Sometimes I don't even know what I'm going to do, so they can't know either.
He's a beast, I
mean.
Pronger knocks Zajac down, penalty.
Well, obviously you disliked him.
Can you swear on TV?
Chris Pronger plays on the edge.
He just stomped on Kessler.
It's not fun.
8 suspensions and more than 1,500 penalty minutes. Pronger is one of hockey's most imposing and intimidating players.
Hawk ties him and throws him down.
If it's already hit, then you have to take it.
Sticks, arms, elbows, helmets flying.
I hated playing against Chris.
Playing near the edge, you're going to cross it once in a while.
A little dirty.
Philadelphia, 2 minutes cross-checking.
Crossing the line if he has to.
Borderline dirty, yeah.
You know, the only people that really matter are the guys in the room. They don't seem to mind the way I play.
The N doesn't stand for national in Pronger's NHL. It stands for nasty. Something his own teammates can speak to as former opponents.
Well, I don't think they really wanted anything to do with 6'6" Chris Pronger.
He's always there just hacking away your lower back, and a couple times after taking 4 or 5, turn around and try and give him a jab, and he'd just give you one swift right, and he kind of, geez, what am I doing here against him?
I skated over the blue line, and I chipped the puck by him, and he whacked me right over the laces. I got it again the next shift, skated over the blue line, chipped it in, whacked me right over the laces. Third time, did it the exact same time, and I kind of gave him a whack back, and he turned around and he skated up to me, and he goes, if you ever whack me again, I'm going to shove that stick down your throat.
Yeah, I probably missed, I maybe missed his hand and got his foot, but there's a good chance that may have happened. You know, I think it's just, you try to get in guys' heads early.
Rubbed out by Pronger. Somebody's on the bottom of the pile, and Pronger's pounding away.
You know, you give him a whack once, and you know, they know you're going to be out there.
Pronger doesn't just leave a mark physically, he plays mind games just as hard.
There weren't too many stories about the games. It was all about this puck that was taken from the ice.
Who steals pucks after games?
I think he was just trying to be a pain in the ass, which he's very good at.
Well, game one, it was right there in front of me, so I picked it up and took it. The second time, yeah, I had to go a little bit further to grab it, but I don't know if it was to get in my head. I was more just kind of piss him off, maybe.
I think Chris Pronger's the biggest idiot in the league. I can't stand the guy one bit. I hope I never have to see him again. And if I see him out there, I might punch him.
You said next time he's going to see, he's going to hit you.
Well, where is that, the minors?
He does, you know, piss off the other opponents. He does, you know, leave a mark physically, mentally.
You want to make sure guys are aware and maybe on edge around you?
The night we won in Anaheim, all the players went to celebrate. One player went and grabbed the puck. Chris Pronger.
The Anaheim Ducks are the Stanley Cup champions.
And so people said afterwards, always selfish, so he wanted to get the puck. He didn't celebrate with his teammates. You know what he did with the puck? He gave it to me after the game. So he's got a heart. He just hides it well.
After punishing opponents for 60 minutes, Pronger can be equally difficult with the media.
Were you waving your hand? Is that right?
What does it matter to you?
Well,
the puck went in the net.
I think his comment was, you know, I don't want to get in that he said, she said argument, and we all know that I'm the he. You know?
I had my arm out, put my arm back on my stick, puck went in the net. I'm not going to get in the he said, she said with the refs. I'm the he.
I think for a lot of media in Philadelphia, Chris Pronger can be an intimidating experience.
So you don't want us to play disciplined?
And I was just wondering, do you get motivated?
Okay, so should we take more penalties? Is that the question?
So I don't do that. Next question.
What do you want me to say?
I really couldn't care, to be honest with you.
Because I don't like the way you phrased your question.
I think I've learned over my years how to handle the media or deal with them.
One at a time. I don't remember anything.
Well, we'll fix your hair first and then.
I'm day to day with hurt feelings.
Well, thanks. Thanks for the green jacket. It's real nice of you.
His responses usually end with a fierce glare or a coy smile, and you're never sure which is real. That's just the way he likes it.
I learned a long time ago to be unpredictable and to not. Sometimes I don't even know what I'm going to do, so they can't know either.